Hey guys, my name's Peter Goldsmith and I'm here in the northeast of the United States at a place called Muncie, Pennsylvania. Believe it or not, there's a Muncie in Pennsylvania and it is the most epic flying site you've ever seen. And of all the people that I met here was Paul Natan. The last time I saw him was at the Horizon Aero Tow. And a little history on Paul, I've got all his videos, not to give him a plug, but I truly have all his videos and I'm an old surfer bum. And he's kind of like a searcher and I used to watch his videos and build all this stuff and dream, man, one day it'd be great to just get out there and see what's going on around the US. So I retired 2 years ago from Horizon. On good terms, everyone's happy. I'm still very connected to Horizon, but it was time to pass the baton. And I started this endeavor to design gliders. Gliding's my roots. I fly all kinds of sailplanes, competition, air launch, ales, scale, free flight, everything. I love anything that's to do with sailplanes. Well, what I've been doing over the last couple of years is designing my own aircraft, mainly scale aircraft, and just designing stuff I want to do. You know, and one of my favorites was a 126. So this is a 40% Schweitzer 126E version. Weighs about 30 pounds, all wood, and it's made on my own little laser cutter. And I actually made the laser cutter. Well, I had a friend and I, we assembled the laser cutter out of a kit and we started making these airplanes. So now I'm manufacturing kits, but the cool thing is I'm really motivated to get people to build again. You know, and there's all kinds of modeling and building's not the best way to do it. I'm not selling that. I'm just saying that there's an aspect. If you haven't built something or haven't built something for a long time, to actually make something with your own hands is just so cool. I use the analogy like a fast food compared to a home-cooked meal. You know, fast food, it's great, it serves a purpose, it's quick and easy and fills you up. But every now and again you want to have a nice home-cooked meal that you prepare yourself, it just tastes better. Well, that's the same with building. You know, everyone should have some kind of winter project and, you know, spend time on it, enjoy the journey, enjoy the assembly of the model, enjoy learning new techniques and enjoy learning to use your hands again. And you'll find there's a big group of guys that are more than happy to share your knowledge and share their knowledge. And you know, I'm not as young as I used to be. And I want that my knowledge to be passed down to the younger kids. So, you know, the younger kids can get involved and learn how to build. Like, you know, when I was young, there was no option. You had to build to be able to do RC. And now there's lots of options. But that doesn't mean building is not fun, you know, we can still make building fun. So I do a range of kits, and I really love the scale soaring. So a lot of my kits are scale sailplanes. I do the 126, I do the Skylark, I do the Swallow. I've got several more in the pipe, plus I do the big tow plane. So I kind of specialized around that area just because it's something that's dear to my heart. But it's great being out here in the northeast in Muncie and seeing my buddy Paul again, and we've been sharing the box and Paul's still doing some great flying as normal, and you know, his videos are awesome as well. So if you want to get involved in building again or just get involved in scale soaring, go and check out scalesoaring.com. It's an awesome website. Everybody that's anybody that's involved in scale soaring goes to that site, so it's a good networking facility. And you'll find that they're a good group of guys as well. They're all over the US. Scale soaring is one of the biggest growing segments right now in RC. And there's 30 to 35 events throughout the US. And on most weekends through the summer, there's one or two events in your area. So especially in the Northeast, very, very active out here in the Northeast. This is Pete Goldsmith Designs, or Peter Goldsmith Designs, Schweitzer 126 E model. The 126 has four designated models. There's the A, B, C, D, and then there's an E model. That's actually five. E model is the latest version. 126 is kind of like the most common sailplane in the US. It's American design, and it's kind of like the Chevy, the Buick, the Model T of sailplanes in the US. So anyone that has any kind of connection to soaring knows about the 126. So one of my favorites, it's a classic. It's kind of goofy but cool at the same time, very low aspect ratio. The real aircraft was designed to match the same performance as the 233, So when the student got out of the 233, which is two place, they hopped into the 126. There wasn't a big jump in the feel of the aircraft. So this was kind of like toned down a little bit performance-wise. So it's kind of a fun glider to fly and keep up. It actually thermals extremely well. It's very aerobatic. It does everything really well. If you just have one glider, this is a fantastic glider. So it's a laser cut kit. It's all plywood, balsa skins, very old school conventional. The wings are all built up, but they're plywood skins, 1/32 plywood skins completely. And you actually build the wing onto the wing skin. Then the front is planked, very old school, very simple structure, and actually quite easy to build, as big as this is. There's three or four now that have been built. Most of the guys said it's as easy as building anything, and you get a lot of aircraft for the amount of time you put in. So a lot of things you'll spend weeks, and you end up with something this big, a box or a radio area or whatever. With this, you spend a week, you've probably got one wing panel built or a stab and a fin. So there's a lot of, it progresses very well. It's very motivational as you build it. It weighs about 30 pounds, or just under 30 pounds. Use the DX18 radio, simple four-channel sailplane, basically, ailerons, rudder, elevator, and spoiler, plus the nose release. And it's just really fun, basic, cool glider to have. Everyone loves it. Did a couple of eight-point rolls and loops and rolls for the guys, and they're like, wow, it's even aerobatic. So, I'm really happy with it. It's growing on me. The more I fly it, the more I don't want to fly anything else. Schweitzer 126, covered in ultra coat, all spectrum servos, power safe receiver, basic all horizon stuff. And I love it. I'm really happy I did it, and I hope other people get to experience it.